Hey BHS, welcome to Second Quarter Video Productions. Here we have the control room. This is the green screen room. And last but not least, welcome to the studio. Please stand for the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag
of the United States of America
and to the republic
for which it stands,
one nation,
under God,
indivisible,
with liberty and justice for all. Thank you.
Hey Ryan, do you get grab and go?
Yeah, I do. The lunch staff works really hard around here.
That's for sure.
It's Jane Sandquist. There's five of us that get here at 5:30 in the morning and they begin breakfast, they bake the cookies, they start lunch, depending on what the menu is for the day. And then I come in at 6:30 and I begin to prepare the tables for first breakfast that go out into the hallways by Lumberjack and by Athletic Doors. And a couple come in and begin to prepare the second chance breakfast, they bag them up and get them all ready to go. When we come back from first breakfast, we set them up on the tables, as you can see. Meanwhile, everybody else is working on lunch, on the salad bars, cutting and preparing the vegetables and fruit. All of our fruit and vegetables are we peel and cut, and the peppers, the jicama, the cucumbers, we prepare all that. The fresh fruit we cut and prepare. Other than the canned fruit, obviously, that comes in. At all times, we wash our hands. The rule of thumb is every time you walk by a sink, you have to wash your hands and wear gloves. When we clean up, we have to count everything. Everything that we put out, we count and measure and weigh. And when we are done at the end of the day, we have to recount and measure because we have to keep records. When we clean up, everything has to be sanitized. So. It has to go through a chemical with bleach water, or it has to go through the dishwasher at high temperatures. But every day, everything has to be sanitized. Both before and after we use the table, it gets sanitized.
Trent, what are you doing?
I'm hunting.
Well, maybe you should learn from the experts.
I'm Archer. I'm Henry. We're gonna teach you how to hunt.
First thing that you need is orange.
Oh my god, because they're not toys. We need to be careful.
Always treat a gun as it's loaded. We're gonna go check some trash before we go hunting.
Love's wine.
There's nothing in it and it's untracked. want to ride a four-wheeler, you always got to wear a helmet.
He saw a grouse, and he started to hunt.
Done driving around, and now we're gonna walk. If you want to go past this, you gotta make sure this is your land.
Be strengthened and be true. We pray for no pain. Thank you for this land. We thank you for our stance. We pray for safety, one and all. We pray for eternal next fall.
See you next season.
Hey, can he stop now?
Trent, are you good at art?
No.
Are you good at sculpting?
No.
What are you good at?
Hunting.
Well, maybe you should have Mr. Ole help you out on that. I was left
to my own. Hi, my name's Mike Ole, and I am the visual art teacher here at Bemidji High School. I wanted to become an art teacher when I found out that I had a little bit of ability to draw myself. The thing I like most about being an art teacher is introducing our young students to new ways of doing things, getting them to explore new media, new ways to express themselves through clay or drawing or digital art, and then getting real excited about hanging and showing their artwork to their friends and family. I think kids who take art in high school are better able to express themselves in the real world. They're maybe not as fearful to try new things.
Thanks for joining us on Lumberjack Live this week.
Here's a sports recap that you missed last week.
Be that young rapping dude, might just trap with you. Coming with the thunder, baby, might just clap it through. I roll out in the morning light with that hood.
I just keep running. Never had it so good, jumping into love. Fires into dry wood, started up as nothing, now it's gold and it's all on you. With God as my witness, never had it so good, jumping into love.